families, friends, students, graduates. Welcome to the St. Croix Preparatory Academy celebration of the class of 2020. I am Shane Mueller, chairperson of the St. Croix Prep Board of Directors. More importantly, though, I am the proud father of a young man graduating from St. Croix Prep today. Like many of you graduating seniors and your families, we are trying to move forward amidst the uncertainty of what the coming months might offer. I wish I could tell you that the path will be clear and smooth, but even in the best of times, it is shrouded in fear, insecurity, and mystery. And as we are all acutely aware, these are not the best of times. So what do? Hide your head in the sand, or grab life by the horns? Should you hope for the best and plan for the worst? Forget all of the cliches. Ask yourself this one question. Will the next steps I take lead me confidently toward my goals? I think yes. Yes, they will, because during the peak of what should have been the best days of your life, you are stoically enduring this unprecedented moment in history. And undoubtedly, the burden must feel disproportionately unfair. And yet with your peers, you strive for inclusivity in this time of isolation. You try to stay connected while social distancing. You have shown immeasurable resilience and courage. It is a time of great uncertainty, and the reality is that our world has changed. Do not let us, your parents, your teachers, your coaches, focus on how unfair this has been to you. Instead, lend us your strength. Urge us to wipe our tears, and let us celebrate and honor your remarkable achievements. On a normal commencement day, I would stand proudly on the dais with Mr. Gutierrez and Mr. Zachariasen, offer you a firm handshake, look you in the eyes, congratulate you on your accomplishment, and wish you well on your journey. While I cannot shake your hand in person, I want you to know that as a representative of the Board of Directors and as a member of this school's community, I say congratulations, class of 2020. We are so proud of you and of your ability to overcome this adversity. Do not let this defeat or discourage you. Do not let it damp your indomitable spirit. Do not let it define you. Instead, go forward and make your lives extraordinary. Congratulations.
On behalf of the faculty of St. Croix Preparatory Academy, I would like to welcome all of you to the graduation of the class of 2020. This has been a challenging year. Our sense of normalcy has been redefined, and our routines have limited our interaction. In my conversations with your teachers, it has become incredibly clear to me that our daily interactions are as important as anything else we do. Hopefully, you can reflect on this year and recognize that the heart and soul of our work together has been strengthened. Seniors, I asked all of you to try and make the best of this situation, and you did, and you will continue to make things work. We're so proud of each of you. You've stepped up and led the way, and you completed the journey. Parents and grandparents, it's truly been an honor to work with your students. Every year around this time, I get a new yearbook, and I page through it, and I look at all the good times we had here together. I think about the growth and maturity of our students, but I also think of our parents. I think about the many conversations, emails, phone calls, and frustrations that we have worked through together. You have trusted us to help overcome these challenges, and there were times you were not sure about how things were going to go. Days when you looked at that senior and you had to dig deep. Parenting is an immense challenge. And I want each of you to know that I counted on you too. It is with this in mind that I would simply like to thank you. I think of all the hard work that you've done to support your student at prep, and I want to take a moment to recognize that. My work at prep is only as strong as our bond to work together to support our kids. I'd also like to thank all of the other people in our graduates' lives that helped influence and shape them. Thank you to our grandparents, coaches, and mentors for everything that you've done to help support your student, not only this year, but throughout their time in school. Graduating from prep is tough, and it's important to take some time to recognize that. There were late nights, frustrations, and hard work. We're not only teaching you how to think like a scientist or to read great works of literature. Our hope is that you do the work because you want to be better yourself. Our hope is to show you how to learn from learning itself and to take that mindset out into the world and find ways to contribute. I'd like to thank all of our wonderful teachers for their hard work and dedication. I'm so proud of the team that we have here in the upper school. Thank you for all that you've done to make this year work out for our kids. Students, I want to thank you and express how proud I am to have had the opportunity to get to know you throughout our time together. I know it's strange to think about how fast these last years in our upper school have come and gone. When third quarter came to an end, we had no idea how the rest of our time together would be impacted. At that time, you might have thought time was standing still. We couldn't have had any idea how this would end, but we can choose how we respond now. And I encourage you to celebrate today. Make sure to take a family photo and send it to us. There are future students who will come to prep and never understand the sacrifices, contributions, and traditions you've made to ensure that our school will continue to be an excellent place to prepare kids for life. Know that you've left a mark on us, and we thank you for this. Seniors, this is it. Let's get after it. I would like to welcome all of you today and thank you for joining us on this special day when we celebrate the graduating class of 2020. We have a tradition of recognizing our seniors who started with us in kindergarten and are graduating today. This year, we have 16 students who we call lifers, having spent all 12 years with us here at prep. These students welcomed new kids into our community and are as deeply connected to their lower school teachers as they are to us. I would typically have you stand up in the gym, but today I'm going to do this a little bit differently. Zachary Doley. Micah Hare. Tommy Ham. Bronwyn Harvey. Grace Hildrum. Taylor Joa. Eli Johnson. Hayden Connery. Madison Marks. Daniel McCarroll. Connor Parr. Mia Sedlacek. Morgan Sedlacek. Macy Sen. Anthony Pribno. And Will Strobing.
congratulations, class of 2020. You've made it. I know this wasn't the senior year that you expected, and certainly none of us did either, but I know at some point in time you will look back at this and be able to talk about it at class reunions or in the future with other family members and remember that this is something that made you special. It made you stronger and it made you flexible and ready to tackle anything. So again, congratulations. Have a super, super graduation day. And even though it's not the one that you planned, make the most of it and we wish you the very best.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. High five.
Kerrigan here, class of 2020. Congratulations. Way to go. Way to stick through it. Way to finish it. Best of luck and best wishes on whatever it is you plan on doing after this year ends. Good luck.
Hi, seniors. It's Mrs. Kleinbull. For some of you, you remember me as your fifth or sixth grade teacher way back in middle school, and others, you've seen me in the hall. But I just wanted to say, congratulations. You did it. And in the midst of things that we just didn't plan for, and that's something that you should be proud of. It's been fun to watch you grow up in these halls at St. Croix Prep, and I'm so excited for the next chapter that you are going to move into. It's full of adventure, and you are ready. So know that while we can't be there to cheer you on, we are, and we're so proud of you. Keep in touch. We always like to know what you are up to. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Greetings, class of 2020. It has certainly been a wild ride, culminating in what I would say is one of the most unusual resolutions to the dramatic arc that is your high school career. Stay motivated, stay dedicated, stay inspired. And remember the words of Don Quixote, the time for books is past. Now is the time for adventure. Congratulations.
Hi, seniors. Mrs. Donna from the lower school here. I just wanted to first apologize for telling you so many times this year to be quiet in the atrium in your study hall. And I hope you use those big, loud, boisterous voices for the good in your future. I know that you're going to do amazing things. You've left such a legacy here at St. Croix Prep, and we're just so, so proud of you. Best of luck to you in the future.
Congratulations, seniors. It's Mrs. Nelson. We are so, so proud of you. We know that you are going to go out into the world and do amazing things. Remember, we are all here sending you our best wishes and all our love. Congrats.
Hey, class of 2020, congratulations, you made it. The world is waiting for you, and I know that you'll make it a better place. Best wishes to all of you.
Hello, SCPA seniors. Class of 2020, congratulations. It's been so fun to meet those of you who have been taking lessons with me in the music department. It's been a pleasure hearing all of you sing, and I want to especially congratulate Anna, Natalie, Calder, Carter, Miriam, Eliza, Connor, Quinn, Henry, Oliver, Andrew, and Elizabeth. It's been so fun. Thank you so much for sharing your voices with me this year. I hope you've learned a lot, and I really, really hope you all continue to sing.
You are SCPA. Congratulations, class of 20. We'll never forget you.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on this special milestone. You may be sick of hearing about the unprecedented time and how strange all of this is. But I want to encourage you in two ways. First, I want you to recognize all of the work that you have put in, the relationships that you have formed, and the legacy that you are leaving for the school. That is something that cannot be taken away from you regardless what is going on globally. Secondly, your experience has the opportunity to shape who you are and what you stand for the rest of your life. I really encourage you to use what you've learned through this time to propel you forward in whatever your pursuits are. This experience will cause some people to lose traction and motivation. I encourage you to be the ones to use this as momentum to push forward and do incredible things. Congratulations, and I look forward to seeing the inspiring work that I know you will do.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
You've made it. We're so proud of you.
Way to go.
You are now going out into the real world to make a difference.
Love, the second grade team.
Nailed it!
All right, and that's a wrap.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I wish you the very best as you begin the next chapter of your life.
Hey, seniors, you worked hard and you made it. Congratulations. Have a great summer and good luck next year.
Hi, it's Mr. Krupper, or Coach Krupp, class of 2020. It has been my honor to spend my first year at St. Croix Prep with you fantastic people. Congratulations on finishing a fantastic education. If anything, 2020 has taught us that all conditions are impermanent. So no matter where you are, make the best of each moment and live in it and be glad. Congratulations again.
Hi, 2020 seniors. Coach Staso here. Congratulations. I just wanted to take a moment to thank you for everything that you are and everything that you've done. I know that each one of you is going to go on to positively impact those around you. Your future schools, employers, athletic teams are going to be immensely blessed by your leadership and your resiliency and your tenacity. We are all so proud of you and the legacies that you have worked hard to build. Please keep in touch, and remember, once a lion, always a lion.
What's going on? This is Mr. Nelson, and I just want to send you a note for the class of 2020. Congratulations on your high school graduation. And as you run your race that's laid out before you in life, and as you pursue your passions and you develop your strengths and your character, again, I just remind you to finish strong, have perseverance, and that will develop the character and the great character that you've developed to this point at St. Croix Prep. So congratulations, and just wish you the best.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. I want to wish you well as you start the next chapter of your journey.
Hey, class of 2020, Mr. Vincent here. Just want to say congratulations, proud of everything that you've done. Thank you for making St. Croix Prep a better place. And don't be a stranger. Make sure you come back, say hi, and maybe we even get one of those alumni big base games going. So congratulations again. Can't wait to see what you do in the future.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I wish you all the best.
Seniors, graduates, class of 2020, I just want to take a minute to tell you how thankful I am for the time I've had with you over these last few years. You are a group of students who motivated teachers to simply be their best. And sometimes, let's face it, it's because you didn't make things easy. You questioned why, you pushed for change, and honestly, these are things that make me so proud of you, especially today. You are game changers. And right now, this moment we're in, this so very strange moment we're in, I think just pushes that further, because you are gonna make something of this moment. Okay, I'm excited for this group to keep asking why and to keep pushing new boundaries. That's what you do. But this place will still be a home that you can come back to. My congrats to the class of 2020. I am so very proud of you, and I'm wishing you the best.
Hello, St. Croix Prep class of 2020. It's Mrs. Argetinger, and I am delighted to come in here and congratulate all of you during this commencement celebration. Of course, I wish we were together, that I could give you a big hug, but I just want to let you know that even if you don't remember me, I truly remember all of you. Your class holds a special place in my heart. You were the last class I taught at St. Croix Prep in my time there as a fourth grade teacher. And I just want to encourage you. I know that this time obviously feels a little bit probably scary, unknown, as you walk into these next moments and days. I know for me, when I had my time at St. Croix Prep, I also felt that as I was leaving my classroom for the last time, from something I knew, something I was so familiar with, a place where I became a part of a community. I honestly met my husband there, so my family grew from that space, into knowing all of you and your families as well. But I also know that there's opportunities now for great adventures to begin, for you to grow in ways you didn't think possible, for you to make your mark on this world in more ways than one. And I know that you were all here and made for such a time as this. So I just wanted to come in here again, say congratulations. It is an honor and a delight to have known you as part of your journey at Prep. And I look forward to seeing and knowing just more how you're going to make an impact on this crazy yet still beautiful world. So congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'll always remember you guys as a group who loved to have fun, who excelled inside and outside of the classroom, and helped us here at St. Croix Prep experience some of our first, right? First group to have teams qualify for state playoffs, excelled, won conference championships, had countless academic awards to go around. And even though the year started off with complaints about cell phones and uniforms and who knows what else, you guys were the first group ever to break Senior Skip Day. You turned Senior Skip Day into a week, into a month, into the rest of the year. So hey, congratulations on ruining Senior Skip Day for everybody else. Congratulations. Don't be a stranger. Come back and visit us. And hey, don't forget to send these pennants in, right? I'd be honored to hang a pennant from you on my wall. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, seniors. For those of you who do not know me, I am Mrs. Celebrity. I teach kindergarten here at St. Croix Prep, and I've been teaching here for 14 years. So I taught some of your classmates. Now I know each of you have your own story. Some of you started out here as a busy bee or a brilliant bear, and some of you came to St. Croix Prep along the way. And getting here has meant a lot of hard work and a lot of determination, and you are each unique. This is an exciting time of your life, and we are so proud of you for what you've done to get here. And we're sorry that the ending is a little different than what you anticipated, but you'll have some great stories to tell as you get older. So congratulations, class of 2020. And if you are a brilliant bear, you probably always heard me say, do your best work. So I'm gonna say that again, do your best work. But I'm also gonna add, love people well. I hope you have a great start to the next part of your life, and we are so proud of you.
Natalie Visich has attended St. Croix Preparatory Academy since first grade. In addition to leading the Science Club's Earth Week the past 2 years, Natalie has been a member of the Math League, National Honor Society, Peer Tutoring, and Prepapella. This fall, she will attend the University of North Dakota State, where she will major in biotechnology. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our distinct privilege to present to you St. Croix Preparatory Academy's 2020 salutatorian, Natalie Visich.
High school, the four-year experience that is generally seen as either the best or the worst years of your life. Well, we finally made it to the end. After 4 years of tests, advisory speeches, and lab reports, we get to walk away with our diplomas. But before I am able to leave the virtual halls of St. Croix Prep, I have one final lab report to submit, a lab report 4 years in the making. So, at long last, it is time to analyze the experiences and lessons we have learned during our high school experiment. Our journey into high school began with repeated warnings from our middle school teachers about how high school teachers are very strict and would not allow us to use notes on tests or accept late work or excuses for incomplete work. Spoiler alert, that ended up not being true. It also began with the stress of trying to figure out which classes to take freshman year, whether honors and AP classes would be nightmarishly difficult compared to standard, and if we really should get those pesky gym, fine art, and language credits done straight away. Luckily, that got easier to navigate as the years went on. The three main things required to survive the prep high school experience included coffee, or your preferred caffeinated beverage, motivation, which in my case was stubbornness, and friends and teachers to help you along the way. From what I've been told, this works not only for high school, but for college and future careers. Oh, and you'll probably need about twice as many writing utensils as you expect. You will end up losing over half of them. The methodology for traversing high school varied from year to year. Freshman year was a bit of a learning curve. Between juggling our new classes, trying to figure out advisory speeches and service hours, and the traditional dislike of freshmen by upperclassmen, things were very chaotic. But we learned how to navigate high school life, connect with older students, and find plenty of new and fun opportunities within extracurriculars. As for sophomore year, well, we managed to figure things out. Life was good, for now. Junior year, the descent into madness to make decisions about our futures began. From PSAT panic, to restructuring our resumes, to canvassing college campuses, we were overwhelmed. And by now, we definitely understood that the initial dislike of freshmen was maybe justified. Our senior year teetered on the edge of calm and chaos. Calm because senior year, and we'd be able to relax a bit more than previous years. There was also the excitement in engaging in senior traditions and getting the chance to put our own spin on some of them. And after 4 years of struggling, we finally managed to win the grade level competition during homecoming week. It took a lot of effort and determination and had absolutely nothing to do with it being rigged for the seniors to win every year. Just simple hard work and strategy. The chaos came in short bursts as we tried to finalize our plans for the future. In the fall, little did we know what true chaos would look like. Even though our last year was cut short, we still managed to make plenty of memories with the time we had together. My data analysis confirms what we all know to be true. Along with academics, character, and leadership, prep has taught us how to survive on 4 hours of sleep, which will be really useful next year, how to say goodbye to those we care about, and that for some odd reason, physics problems become a lot more fun after midnight. We learned how to connect with people in ways we never expected, as well as the benefits and the downfalls of having such a small community. Most importantly, it has taught us that things don't always work out the way you expect them to, and that it's okay to ask others for help. Over the past few months, we have definitely seen and experienced how things don't go according to plan. At the start of the year, we were expecting to have all of the traditional senior experiences. Last prom, senior dinner and boat ride, extremely crowded graduation in the gym, but here we are. Sure, it might be disappointing now that we missed out on all of that, but in the long run, it really won't matter. Sometimes sacrificing the small things is necessary when looking at the bigger picture. In 20 years, are any of us really going to care that we didn't get to skip school for a day or be devastated that we didn't get to take pictures with friends in our caps and gowns? Instead, we have unique memories and experiences that no other graduating class has experienced. Watching catwalk across the teacher's keyboard in the middle of class, having an important Zoom call dissolve into everyone showing off their dogs. Hey, at least we finally managed to get that puppy room for AP testing. And having staff members mysteriously sneak into our yards to drop off lawn signs. And I suppose many, many years down the road, if our kids complain about something going on in their high school, we can always pull the, well, when I was your age, I was living through a pandemic card. Now that we've completed our prep experience, it is time for us to go out into the world and use all that we have learned here to make it through the calm and the chaos the future holds. Sure, things will be a little rough at first. We are going to be freshmen again in a new environment, trying to make new friends, and being away from the people we care about. But if this year has taught us anything, it is that we are well-equipped to face this next stage in our lives. I'd like to thank Mr. Gutierrez, Mr. Zachariasen, and all of our teachers for the outstanding experience you have provided us. To all of my classmates, congratulations. I wish you the best of luck.
Senior Representative Hans Gebauer has been a student at St. Croix Preparatory Academy for 8 years. During this time, he has been active on the speech and debate teams, the St. Croix Prep Quiz Bowl team, and has written for the Prep Quarterly in addition to serving as president of the Student Council. This fall, he will attend Regis University in Denver, Colorado, where he plans to pursue a double major in Peace and Justice Studies and Economics on a full academic scholarship. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Hans Gebauer.
Good afternoon, graduates, parents, and families. It's an honor and a privilege to speak here today. It's an honor to share in the intense emotions of such a special occasion, and a privilege to address my friends at what might be the last time the class of 2020 is together, even if I'm in a recording studio and you're watching a live-streamed ceremony. I remember that first day of school less than 4 years ago, when we began our freshman year with eagerness and anticipation, as we looked towards this day and thought, it's so close. As the days grew longer, the homework stacked up, and each spring semester seemed more drawn out than the last. Our last moments at prep felt as if they had only slipped further into the distant future. And then came senior year. And we all came back in September to begin this school year. It was our last first day of school, and then it was our last homecoming week, and then a few months later, it was our last Sadie's dance. And not too long ago, we all looked forward to our last time dancing at prom, our last day in painting one, and our last day together as one class in cap and gown. Maybe we tell ourselves this is our last because we're trying to make ourselves enjoy it just that much more. Unfortunately, reality has exposed the greatest flaw with this way of thinking. When we say this is our last, we're actually living in every moment except the present. Instead of living in the last days before spring break, we were already fixated on our vacation plans, and beyond that, our last days in class. It's ironic that we'd become so entrenched in the anticipation that we actually let those days slip past us. At its core, thinking in terms of firsts and lasts is pure hype that matures into nostalgia when the night is over and all is said and done. It's the ultimate challenge of youth, and I imagine the ultimate challenge of the human experience. Live in the moment. And I don't have to tell you that this time of global crisis and inescapable shutdowns around us only makes this challenge more apparent. How do we live in the moment? If we reflect back on our freshman selves, every graduate watching, with no exceptions, would say that they have changed in some important way. It's a lot to take in when we compare ourselves today to the class that began freshman year 4 years ago. It's too much to take in. We can't possibly capture all the most enriching moments that have slowly made us who we are today, with reflection and reflection alone. Instead, we need to reconsider how we think about ourselves as time passes, not in terms of firsts and lasts, but everything in between. We need to ask ourselves, how much more fulfilling can our lives be if we live conscious of change as it's happening, instead of using the mere footnotes that we call firsts and lasts to define our lives? We've got 4 more years until we're seniors all over again. And I know I don't want to stand in cap and gown after just 4 more years of firsts, lasts, and reflections with holes and gaps. It's something I've learned after a few years of exploring exactly who I am, and it's made this past year exponentially more meaningful. I challenge us all to move forward and deepen our lives in the time that falls between our firsts and our lasts. To be aware of all the different shades of change as it happens. That means change in our shared world, change in our soon-to-be distant communities, and most importantly, change in ourselves. But before we go on to shape the world, wherever we may be called, it's important to recognize the people who made today possible. So thank you to our parents, each other, our faculty and teachers, our coaches, and our friends who will graduate in the coming years. We all know that we wouldn't be the same people without your company, support, encouragement, and guidance. Thank you.
Oliver Yoakum has attended St. Croix Prep for 12 years. He has served as Secretary of the Student Council, an officer in the Science Club, President of the National Honor Society, and has served 2 years as the captain of the varsity boys soccer team, where he has lettered all 4 years. He has also been a member of the Quiz Bowl team, Math League, Debate team, Prepapella, and has volunteered as a peer tutor. This fall, he plans to attend Northwestern University in Evanston, Illinois, where he will major in mechanical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the high privilege and distinct honor of presenting to you St. Croix Preparatory Academy's 2020 valedictorian, Oliver Yoakum.
I've kind of been dreaming about this speech for a while. I mean, I had a tie picked out since a year and a half ago, and a dream to make it to the finish line since even before then. And well, I did it. I mean, I put my head down and worked for day in, day out, nonstop to finish my schoolwork ahead of time. Well, sort of. If you know anything about my schoolwork schedule, it may have looked just a little bit different and a little bit more last minute. But I mean, the results still count, right? I hope so. But in that time when I set my mind on accomplishing something, I knew that this speech had to be great. It had to encompass my entire school experience, be thoughtful, and just a pinch of funny. But whoa, some big stuff happened this year, so this better be good. Well, I'll try my best. Man, it has really been a year. All the classic senior moments like fall sports, homecoming, winter week, and worldwide pandemic. I really didn't see that one coming. And just like that, out went a few real big traditions. But at least I didn't have to make a deal-breaking decision whether to face Mr. Hasselberger's wrath on senior skip day. So hey, there's at least one plus side. During my time at prep, which is 12 years to be exact, sorry prep for lifers, I was a little bit late to the party. I've learned a lot. This place has changed me for the better. It's seen me grow up, switch sports, take the MCAs, captain a team, and find a fantastic group of people that I couldn't be prouder to call my friends. When I was sitting in the old Herberger's parking lot on the second day of school, age 6, circa 2008, I couldn't have imagined a future quite like this. With my parents asking me whether or not I want to go to this odd-looking school with an asphalt courtyard as a playground, I wasn't exactly sure what to think. All I could really think of was that I desperately wanted out of my old school, and I was a little scared for my life on the first day of first grade when I was seated right next to a girl who proudly proclaimed that she had lice. Easy decision for prep there, and I couldn't have been happier with my choice. The class of 2020 has been a remarkable one. We've created record-breaking athletic seasons, brought up some exceptional students, and become extremely involved leaders for the rest of the school. We've continued to express spirit and engagement through this trying time, which is a great feat in and of itself. I can proudly say that we've markedly improved our reputation from the questionable notoriety that we entered high school with. Well done, everyone, and thank you, teachers, for bearing with us. Looking back on senior year, high school, and all of my time at St. Croix Prep, it seems clear to me that prep has given me so many memories, ones that I'll cherish for a lifetime. Something I'll really never forget is the time I decided it was a reasonable idea to go straight down a hill and hit a jump on skis. Except they weren't downhill skis, these were cross-country skis. So I go straight down the hill, and about halfway down, I realize I'm going a little bit too fast. Too late to turn back now, though. I hit the jump, and immediately, my skis tangle in the air, and I land horrendously. Oh no, something's up with my leg. It turns out I fractured my femur. Not the best feeling in the world, I can't admit. You'd think I learned from my experience and my 3 months in school in a full leg cast, but not quite yet. 2 winters later and I'm speeding straight downhill again, of course, but this time on alpine skis. No speed check, no fear, and straight up in the air. 15 feet and a crash on my tailbone later and I'm taking a ride to the emergency ski patrol snowmobile. Uh-oh, again. This time I'm let off easy with a few compressed vertebrae, but I think I finally learned my lesson. I'm no Matty Dean, and from now on I think I'll be grounded when I go skiing. So I'm not saying break bones, but those experiences were beautiful in their own way. I'll never forget the risks that I took, even when the payout wasn't exactly as expected. But that's the spice of life. From the numerous broken arms in that old Herberger's parking lot, to the school closures and negative 60 degree wind chill, even the not so perfect memories are something that bring us together. Especially now, the same is true. Through good times and through the bad, we learn, we remember, and we laugh. It's memories like these that make up our experience, not just for school, but for life in general. Extended memory is one of the many things that makes us human. It allows for the development of lifelong relationships, inside jokes, and unique interests that makes us who we are. To take advantage of these beautiful things that we call memories, we have to always be making new ones. Finding a way to make your days and your hours intentional gives you something to look back on and be proud of, but it also gives you something to look forward to and to be excited for the new memories you'll make in the future. As we depart from the familiarity of prep and the home as we know it, we look forward to exciting new moments that we'll share, that will live with us forever. There's so much more to do, and we've only really just scratched the surface. As we grow and we accomplish more and more, let's make sure that we appreciate the people who have been there for us along the way. People here have been so genuinely interested in our well-being, and it's gone a long way for our experiences. So we thank you, staff, we thank you, teachers, we thank you, parents, for the impact that you've made on us. It's something that we really won't forget. So as we start to focus on our own individuality and finding ourselves in the world, don't forget the moments that we've shared with people you love and in places that you cherish. But go and make more memories. They're waiting for you. So if I have one message to you, it's this. Make the future memorable. You're beyond capable of it. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2020.
To the class of 2020, this is the time when I normally step up, gaze over a filled gymnasium, see the excitement and anticipation of all of you, and together we share the graduation address. This is all so different, as you stare into a screen and I look into a camera. But we can do this, right? Yes, we can. Let's go. And once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain. When you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what this storm's all about. These words by Japanese author Haruki Murakami describe our situation today. This is different. You see, storms in Minnesota, we're used to them. Turn on the weather. We see the forecast. We know when the storm will start. We know when the storm will end. And we see the impact. Then we recover. We dig out. And usually a couple of days later, all is back to normal. But not this storm. No, not the storm of COVID-19. We can't see it. We can't predict it. And we won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. So today, right now, here we are. My message to you graduates, the class of 2020, I'm not even sure I know what to say. Perhaps I will start with this. I am sad, and I know in many ways this is also sad for you. Grieve your loss, but don't be overwhelmed. Grieve your loss, but don't be overwhelmed. I don't want to relive this, but I truly believe this is part of our process. So please, please, hang in there with me. It was Friday, March 6th, the last day of classes before spring break. Do you remember? There was excitement in the air, a break, vacation, time off. You may have traveled. You may have stayed home. You may have spent time with friends. Monday, March 16th, it was to be the first day back at prep. Then you got the announcement, another 2 days off. Yes! Then the announcement that classes will resume on Monday, March 30th. Next, come clean out your lockers, pick up your supplies, books, and equipment. What is happening? What's going on? Learning from home? Seriously? March 30th turns to May 5th, and now here we are, the end of the school year. Grieve your loss, but don't be overwhelmed. What about winter sports banquets, the plays, the concerts? How about spring sports, prom, my college visits, senior skip day? What about the senior dinner, the boat trip, graduation parties? My friends, I want to be with my friends. The rites of passage. Mr. Gutierrez, I want to walk across the stage. May I please have something? You are sitting with your family. They share your loss. Your parents want so much more for you. Your siblings want so much more for you. We all want so much more for you. St. Croix Prep has experienced loss too. On occasion, I walk through the building, the very empty building, the lifeless shell of what we are. We are not a building, we're a community. We miss you. We miss your life, your energy, your laughter, and your dreams. Grieve your loss, but don't stop there, because once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it, how you managed to survive. Survival. Manage your survival by planning each day. You have already survived. Today is May 31st, and all this began on March 16th. How did you do it? Do you remember? During many graduation ceremonies, I often insert a paragraph that goes something like this. Listen, listen, listen. The sound of silence. The whispers of your dreams are knocking on the doorstep of your heart, and you can only hear it when you silence the blaring sounds that creep in upon us. The great omission in our life is solitude, the time and space which is free from the outside pressures. This quietness and solitude is the incubator of our spirit. Today, all we have is time, and the time is filled with silence. But now the silence is deafening. It is far from calming. It is haunting, and often it is torturous. This adversity has held us back from places we want to go, people we want to see, experiences we expected to enjoy. It seems that so much has been torn away from us. What remains? What is left? There is you, and there is time. We must somehow and in some way find beauty in the boredom and treat the silence as a sanctuary. You are in a storm, so take time to plan each day. Each day, spend time with your friends. I know this is exactly what you want to do, but you can't do it in the ways you normally do, so do it differently. Call them on your phone. Listen to their voice. Ask them how they are feeling, what they are struggling with. Write them a letter. Tell them you appreciate their friendship. Each day, spend time with your family. I know what you're thinking. You already are spending time with your family. Too much time. So do it differently. Cook a meal together, do a puzzle, watch a Netflix series together, even if it is Tiger King. Read a book out loud. Tell your family why you appreciate them. Each day, spend time with yourself. Now I know you think I must be crazy because this is exactly what you seem to be doing all the time. So do it differently. Take time to explore, to wonder, to dream, exercise, play music, learn to code, build or fix something, plant a garden, draw, read a book, any book, journal, lay in the grass, look up at the sky. Take time to think, to feel, to dream, to appreciate who you are. And notice, there is no one like you. You are amazing. As I say this, I want you to know, I'm not giving you more things to do. I'm giving you the freedom to simply be, to learn what truly matters to you. I know at this point you're probably wondering, why is this important? Why? Because one thing is certain, when you come out of the storm. One thing is certain, the storm will eventually be over. Don't ever wonder if this storm will be over. One thing is certain, you will come out of the storm. And when you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. How will you be different? And will you be ready to live your life? When you come out of the storm, you must live your life by chasing your dreams. Live your life by chasing your dreams. And the only way you can live your life is by being yourself. You must be yourself. Because there's no one else just like you, no one with the same skills, no one with the same personality, no one with the exact same experiences, no one with the same desires, no one with the same pain. You must be you, because within you lies greatness, within you lies compassion, within you lies intelligence, within you lies thoughtfulness, love, creativity, and acceptance. Within you lies the gifts and dreams that are only yours. Be yourself. Be yourself. Live your life by chasing your dreams, and you must chase your dreams. What do you want more than anything? What can you not live without? What is it that you must do? Right now, at this very moment, you are preparing for great opportunity. Will you make the most of it? You must. Your dreams, chase them, pursue them, run them down, track them. This is your relentless pursuit of your life. And when you chase your dreams, you must never, ever give up. If it matters to you, never give up. Do not be afraid to fail. Embrace it and fail forward toward your dreams. Calvin Coolidge said, "Nothing in this world can take the place of persistence." Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful people with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination are omnipotent. You must never give up. Grieve your loss, but do not be overwhelmed. Manage your survival by planning each day. Live your life by chasing your dreams. As I prepared this message, I thought long and hard. If for some reason in 5 years, 10 years, maybe in 20 years, you came across this message again, will it matter? Will these words be relevant? I contend they are. Yes, they are, for you see, this is a message about life. Disappointment, loss, sadness, a message about how to handle adversity, about pointing yourself on the road to new opportunity, the belief in possibility. And knowing that through hard work, effort, and overcoming obstacles, your life can be as you want it. And so once again, I leave you with these words. And once the storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain. Yes, one thing is certain. When you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. To the class of 2020, congratulations. Well done.
Mamayama Afria Adabur. Quinn Noel Alabuni. Camille Ellen Allaire. Joseph Gregory Baumgarten. Carter Dwayne Blyle. Barrett William Benson. Nathan William Bogle. Clara Ruth Brucker. Benjamin Bidlin. Mario Luis Chilifone. Lauren Marie Chavala. Miriam Cooper. Madison Patricia Dean. Zachary Stephen Doley. Calder Hawking Erickson. Hannah Rose Flynn. Isabel Marie Gardner. Hans Christian Gebauer. Sadie Ann Gilmeister. Elizabeth Grace Goodman. Evan Kale Gutierrez. Micah Andrew Hare. Catherine Linda Halley. Thomas Joseph Hamm. Bronwyn Olivia Harvey. Severin Lorenz Hegstad. Jordan Julia Hetrick. Elizabeth Rose Haying. Grace Ann Hildrum. Amanda Lynn Holmberg. Andrew Stephen Horgan. Britta Jean Hornback. Jacob James Jaros. Taylor Ann Joa. Eli Trace Johnson. Grace Catherine Klingsporn. Hayden Edward Connery. Brenna Rain Lindstrom. Lindsay Shea Malachy. Madison Ray Marks. Megan Patrice Matara. Daniel Wesley McCarroll. Isaac John McMullen. Enrique Mendez Gayton. Julia Brooke Miller. Jackson Bradley Moffitt. Henry Elliott Mueller. Grace Elaine Mullen. Anders Robert Nass. Anna Catherine Nelson. Christina Marie Nelson. Sasha Leah Nelson. Matthew Nipson. Emily Ann Marie Newman. William North. Connor Michael Parr. Alicia Elizabeth Poppy. Anthony Scott Pribno. Grace Margaret Pugh. Parker William Reimer. Carter Charles Rognes. Sydney Lucinda Sanders. Mia Amber Sedlacek. Morgan Ann Sedlacek. Macy Louise Sen. Benjamin David Silvernail. Rishi Raj Singh. William Charles Strobing. Faith May Taylor. Sansuki Lauren Tao. Natalie Jean Visich. Annalise Karen Vlieger. Grant Adam Walnoffer. Anna Corinne Westby. Amy Shaban Whitcomb. Shelby Ruth Whiting. Carson David Whitman. Chloe Catherine Weinholz. Emma Frances Wearing. Nikki Annalie Williamson. Emma Nicole Wolf. Isaac Gawain Woodman. Isabella Renee Woog. And Oliver Yoakum. It is my honor to present to you the class of 2020.
that you spend your days, but they all add up. I'll say I live.